Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on signs and symptoms of a bad cabin air filter. Cabin air filters in vehicles are likely one of the most overlooked standard maintenance items. However, they are very important to ensuring safe, healthy, clean air inside of the cabin of the vehicle. Cabin air filters are responsible for keeping the air clean in there. They help eliminate any particles, dust, dirt, debris, any allergens from entering the cabin of the vehicle by getting stuck in the filter. And essentially, just like any other air filter would work, whether it's for your engine or your HVAC system at home, these cabin air filters in vehicles are equally important to ensure that you're getting sufficient quality air flowing into the cabin of the vehicle. Much like your engine air filter, cabin air filters are just a standard maintenance item. Most recommend replacing the cabin air filter roughly every 1 to 3 years, or about 15 to 30,000 miles. Now, if you're someone who suffers from allergies or other potential respiratory or breathing issues, you might even consider replacing that cabin air filter even sooner than that, just to ensure that, again, you are getting the cleanest, highest quality air possible into the vehicle. With that said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss a few of the most common signs and symptoms of a bad or clogged cabin air filter. So number one, we have decreased airflow coming through the vents in the vehicle. Now this one's very straightforward. The cabin air filters are obviously responsible for filtering the air entering the cabin. And one of the most common causes of a bad cabin air filter is it simply becoming dirty or clogged. And ultimately, when that filter becomes dirty or clogged, you limit the amount of air that can actually be pulled through the filter and into the cabin. So if you're noticing the vents in your vehicle are blowing air a lot weaker than they used to, or you can hear the blower motor maybe working a lot harder than it used to, and you're not getting any additional airflow through those vents, then those can all be indications that your cabin air filter or filters are clogged or dirty. So at that point, if you're noticing that decrease in airflow, that's a great time to go ahead and check out those cabin air filters. They're very easy to access and check. And on most vehicles, it will only take you 5 or 10 minutes. So that's a great time to go ahead and check those filters, make sure they aren't too dirty or too clogged. And if they are, obviously a good time to go ahead and replace them. Moving on to symptom number two, we have bad smells and odors in the cabin. If you're smelling anything musty or sour, or really just any kind of foul smells in the cabin of the vehicle, then that very well may be caused by the cabin air filters. Now, one thing to keep in mind here is if you're just picking up on the smell every so often, or in certain conditions, there are a number of different things that can create different odors in the cabin of the vehicle. For example, if you have some sort of fuel leak or some sort of oil leak that's potentially dripping onto hot components and burning off, those vapors could actually get pulled through into the cabin. And so that might not have anything to do with the cabin air filters, or it could even just be normal smells from outside. But still, if you're noticing these foul odors, especially for extended periods of time in your vehicle, then that very well may be due to bad, old, and dirty cabin air filters. Moving on to sign and symptom number three, we have foggy windows and windshields that take a lot longer to clear. Windshields and windows in cars fog up when you have significant differences in the air temperature, pressure, and humidity inside of the vehicle compared to outside of the vehicle. And so in these situations, the windows fog up and the air vents and air coming into the cabin are very important in keeping those windows fog free. So if you're noticing your windows are fogging up a lot more or struggling to defog them once they do fog up, then that can be an indication of a clogged or dirty cabin air filter. And the reason for that, again, is airflow related. Once that filter becomes clogged, you won't have as much air flowing into the cabin, which can make it harder to clean off the windshield with your defroster, or even just the windows with your vents on the vehicle helping clear those off. So if you're noticing issues with fog in the cabin and it taking longer to clear up, then the cabin air filter is a great starting point. For symptom number four, we have more dirt and debris inside the vehicle. With these cabin air filters, as they age, and especially as they get dirtier, that can allow more and larger particles of dust, dirt, debris, any kind of particles into the cabin of the vehicle. So if you're noticing more stuff coming through the vents, or just noticing that you have more dust or dirt near a vehicle than usual, and it's accumulating faster, then that can be a sign that your cabin air filter needs replacing. So go ahead and check that if you're noticing the inside of the car is just feeling dirtier, especially if it's happening a lot more suddenly than it used to. And last but not least, for symptom number five, we have sneezing, allergies, or any other potential respiratory problems. So again, these air filters are very important for keeping the air quality inside your vehicle safe, clean, and healthy. And so as they get older, dirtier, and worn down, that can allow more of these particles and potential allergens into the cabin of the vehicle, which can in turn trigger your allergies or sneezing or other issues along those lines. Of course, that could also be medically related stuff, and so you don't just want to assume it's your cabin air filter, but if you know you have something like allergies and they're suddenly getting a lot worse, especially when you're sitting in your vehicle or driving your vehicle, then that can certainly be a sign that that cabin air filter is old, dirty, and worn down, and it's a good time to go ahead and replace that to ensure you're getting the freshest, cleanest air into the vehicle. So ultimately, that wraps up the most common signs and symptoms of a bad or dirty cabin air filter. In summary, a lot of the times these symptoms are very straightforward. However, cabin air filters can still be a very overlooked maintenance item. I know myself, even personally, I am guilty of forgetting about that and thinking more so along the lines of engine maintenance rather than overall vehicle maintenance. And these cabin air filters, again, are very important to ensure that you have a safe, healthy, and clean environment inside the cabin of your vehicle. So if you're noticing any of these symptoms like decreased airflow, poor air quality inside the vehicle, allergens, etc., then that's a great time to go ahead and check out and potentially replace that cabin air filter. They should be replaced roughly every 1 to 3 years or about 15 to 30,000 miles. And again, as I mentioned earlier in this video, if you do suffer from allergies or other issues like that, then you might consider replacing it even sooner just to ensure you are getting the cleanest possible air into the cabin of the vehicle. As a final note about replacing these cabin air filters, they are very simple on most vehicles to access and replace. Most people could do it at home, in the driveway, in the garage in about 5 to 15 minutes. Some vehicles it might take a little bit longer, but in almost all cases you should be able to do it in less than 30 minutes. And a cabin air filter costs about $15 to $50 on average, so it's a relatively inexpensive maintenance item and a great way to ensure that you have a safe, healthy, and clean environment inside of your vehicle. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.